Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial, and today we're looking at what you need to know before you start selling on sites like Spoonflower, Etsy, Creative Market, and Redbubble. So say, for example, you're designing patterns and you want to start selling on one or some of these sites. What do you need to know before you do what I am about to do, which is open up Photoshop and get started designing? Well, this is the totally wrong thing to do. You shouldn't be opening up Photoshop because right now you don't know what you're going to sell. So what you need to do before you start selling is go do your research. I know it sounds boring, I know it sounds tedious, it's not nearly as much fun as Photoshop, but you really, really need to do it. So what you're going to do is you're going to crank up your favorite browser and you're going to go and look for the information that you need. Now, for example, I'm over here at Spoonflower and I do have a lot of stuff on Spoonflower. I like Spoonflower because they have a pretty good help section that explains to you pretty clearly what they need. And Spoonflower is very different to all these other sites, well, most of them anyway, because Spoonflower wants the pattern swatch. So when you upload to Spoonflower, you're not uploading a document like this. You're actually uploading the pattern swatch. And from this, Spoonflower makes a design that will fill whatever it is that you want to buy. You may want to buy a fat quarter of fabric. You may want to buy wallpaper. Spoonflower is just going to keep the repeat going over and over again until it fills the document. So it's very, very different to the other site. So if you're going to design for Spoonflower, you need pattern swatches. You also will be able to see here that you're going to be designing in RGB color mode, well, sRGB color mode. You're also going to be delivering a JPEG or a PNG with your pattern swatch. You want to save it at your preferred print dimensions and 150 DPI. These are critical things that you need to know before you can even begin to open Photoshop. Now, other sites are very different. For example, Redbubble actually wants you to upload the document that is going to be used to fill whatever it is that you're making, whether it be an iPhone case or a set of bed sheets. So you're designing something, you're going to upload a document that's filled with your pattern or your design, and it's going to be at a size where it could be used for bed sheets or an iPhone case. So you need to think really big on Redbubble. So think in terms of uploading a document that is at least nearly 10,000 by 6,000 pixels in size. Here, their dimensions here. This is going to cover their entire range of products that are offered on Redbubble. So on Redbubble, it's not about the pattern swatch. It's all about the finished document. And you can read here in the Redbubble Help Center exactly what you need to have created to be able to make your products or sell your products here on Redbubble. Now, Etsy, again, is very, very different. Etsy, unfortunately, does not give a lot of information about what you need to provide. So, for example, if you're selling scrapbook paper on Etsy, what I would suggest you do is go and look up scrapbook paper on Etsy and go and find some of their star sellers. Star sellers are people who are selling a lot of stuff. Not only do you get an idea as to what might sell on Etsy, but you'll also get an idea as to how you're going to produce those documents. There are also some really good ideas here. This is the one I wanted to show you here, is this watercolor stripes. I've got it open here. What this person did was that they created a single set of watercolor stripes and then they just recolored it over and over again. So they've got a huge number of scrapbook papers pages in this document, but they're all the exact same original design, just recolored. It's literally a hue saturation adjustment layer that they've used. This is bog simple stuff to create, but they're a bestseller on Etsy. Now, they're going to tell you here what they're actually giving you, their JPEG files. That's really important. They're also going to be RGB files. My bet would be that they are going to be that. They're high resolution at 300 DPI. They don't have watermarks, and each sheet of paper is 12 by 12. So 12 by 12 at 300 DPI means that these are 3600 by 3600 pixel sheets of scrapbook paper. Now, if you're unsure as to how to package these up, what I would do is go and find a fairly cheap package from a popular seller, go and buy it, download it, open it up, and have a look and see how they're producing their content. What's interesting here on Etsy is that this person has 5 images for selling their scrapbook paper, not just their master image, but some additional images as well. Learn from what they're telling you about their product, because that, if you want to sell on Etsy, if you want to sell scrapbook paper on Etsy, that's what you're going to be selling. And let's have a look at Creative Market. Now, Creative Market, again, you're going to have to fish around to find information out. So here I'm looking at graphic patterns. And so you could come in here to these designers here on Creative Market and have a look and see what it is that they're producing. Have a look and see how they're packaging their stuff, what documents or what provision they are doing in terms of giving you the original pattern, the swatch or something that's filled with it, whatever. So you need to do a whole heap of research before you get started. And I suggest that you gather things together in, for example, a file. So I've got a Word file here. This is for Spoonflower. I've made some notes about what sort of things are uploaded to Spoonflower. I'm going to add sRGB to this so that I upload an RGB file. I've also copied some of the stuff from their website and I've provided for myself that link. So if I ever need to go back to it to refer to it, I can. So choose the sites that you plan to sell on, do some research, determine exactly what it is that you're going to need to produce to upload, and also make some notes about the sorts of things that you might need to provide an intending purchaser. Lots of images about your product, how you're going to package things together. The more research you do and the clearer you are in terms of what it is that you need to produce for that site, the work that you do inside Photoshop is going to go a whole lot more quickly because you're going to know exactly what it is that you need to produce. The other thing is you might notice that things are easier than you thought. For example, as I said, this person's got one sheet of scrapbook paper, they've recolored it 30 odd times and they've got a bundle. You don't need to overthink this stuff. It can be quite simple to produce a set of scrapbook paper. You don't have to design 34, 35 original sheets, just one and recolor it. Not everybody is like this, but you'll see quite a few people who are selling stuff like that. Here's another one. They've just created a plaid design and recolored it over and over again. If you want to boost a shop and get started with quite a bit of product very quickly and easily, then this is a way to do it. I hope this information has been of help to you and will streamline the process of getting started making product to sell on the site that you choose to sell on. Before we finish up, you'll find that I have more Photoshop training at Skillshare.com, including a lot of pattern making classes. When you sign up for Skillshare, you get access to thousands of classes there, including over 270 of mine. In the description below is a Skillshare coupon for you, which is at least as good as the current Skillshare offer. Typically, mine will be better. Please feel free to share this coupon with family, friends, and co-workers. If you enjoyed this video, you know what to do. Give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you'll be alerted when new videos are released. Until next time, my name's Helen Bradley. Thank you so much for joining me here on my YouTube channel.